Good day, friends. Today's video is a video that I created some time ago. Before I placed videos on YouTube, I did it on Facebook. And I had some problems there, so I decided to come over to YouTube. But this video, both these videos I created in 2017. Now, this video I'm to share with you today is the rapture of the church is only the first fruit of the barley harvest. It's not a church that will be raptured. That's a complete wrong teaching, the error of many pastors, teachers that say that a church will be raptured. It's not a church that will be raptured. The rapture is a very fine line. The Bible say he comes for a spotless bride, people. You know what that means? Almost without sin. Now in Bali there is no leaven. Jesus was the first fruits from the dead. The first fruits of many. He spoke of first fruits. So what does that mean? There is multiple. There's multitude of first fruits as well. And that is what I'm going to discuss in this video. And I'm making a sample, a video of a tomato tree that is in my garden. So you can sit back and watch that video. So please remember, it's only the first fruit of the church. Many are called, but only few is chosen. Very few will be chosen. If you look at the Republicans or the Democrats or any government in the country, there are few ministers that they can select from. But there's only one out of the three or four that will be chosen. So that's the same with the Bride of Christ. So please do sit back and watch this video. Then there is another video, this video, the raptures in the harvest cycle that I want to watch with this video. So watch the first video that I present to you now, and then watch this video, the raptures in the harvest cycles of Israel. That video count is 1753. I will check it out and see if you watch it. This is very important. It's a good teaching video that explains the raptures in the harvest cycles of Israel. It's all based upon Israel. It's very important that you know the feast of God. The feast of God is not for Israel people. That's another wrong error. God's salvation plan is in the feast. That's where it is. It's in the feast. The feast of God is the salvation plan of God. I really hope you begin to understand that. And if you don't learn it now, you'll probably learn that in heaven. And even in the millennium, you will observe the feast. So what's wrong in observing it now? Well, the feast is over this year. I don't know if you'll have an opportunity next year, 2020. To celebrate God's feast. Okay, so that's all that I want to say. Please do subscribe and please press the notification button and share the videos. Thanks so much. Thank you.
Good day, happy friends. As you can see in front of you is not a picture, but a bowl of tomatoes, or tomatoes as some call it. This is from just one tree that, not a particular garden, but just one tree that came up in my in the garden, I would say. And it produced 24 tomatoes. As you can see, most of it is green, and there are only 1, 2, 3, 4 that is ripe. Now, I made an example in one of my posts about my tree as the first fruits, about the rapture. The rapture is the first fruits of the church. It's not the church that is going to get raptured, but only the first fruits. And if you look in this bowl of tomatoes, then you will see that all of them is green. And there's an idiom about the word green. An Afrikaans sê hulle is nog groen agter jou ore. You can interpret that or translate it yourself. Yeah, so there's only four, and there is one another one that is getting ripe. But I don't think that tomato will be in time for the rapture. So you'll find that most of the church is going to stay behind. Are you ready? Are you one of those green ones? Or are you ripe like those red tomatoes? That is the question. So be ready, friends. Be always ready. Yeshua desires a spotless bride. Now, what is first fruits? Let us just get that in the picture. What is first fruits? First fruits is a feast unto God. Now, many would say it is a Jewish feast. I don't agree with that. First fruits was a feast held in early spring at the beginning of the grain harvest. It was observed in the month of April, as we know it, or called Nisan, the 15th, which was the third day after Passover and the second day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread. Now, first fruits was a time of thanksgiving for God's provision. Now, you can find this all in the book of Leviticus. Leviticus 23:9-14 states that says this about the first fruit offering. The people were to bring sheaves of grain to the priest, who would wave it before the Lord. A burnt offering, a meal offering, and a drink offering were also required at that time. Deuteronomy 26:1-10 gives even more detail on the procedure, on the procedure of the first fruits. No grain was to be harvested. Listen carefully. No grain was to be harvested at all until the first fruits offering was brought to the Lord. Leviticus 23:40. Now the offering was made in remembrance of Israel's journey in Israel. Now if you go to Matthew 27:52, you'll find that on the day that Jesus died on the cross, that graves opened. But they did not come out of the graves until the first day when Jesus rose from the dead. So where did those people go to? Jesus said to Mary Magdalene in the garden, she thought he was the gardener. And Jesus said to her, do not touch me. Now, why did Yeshua say that Mary Magdalene should not touch him? Because he didn't, he says clearly, for I didn't go unto my father yet. But 8 days later, 8 days later, Thomas could touch him. That you find very strange. So what happened to those people that came out of the graves? They were the first fruits from the dead. And if we know the scripture in Thessalonians, it says that the dead in Christ will rise first. And we that are alive will be caught up with Jesus in the air. Okay, so that is first fruits.
I just want to add on quickly here towards the end. After you watch this next two videos, the rapture comes at the, it's only the first fruit of the barley harvest of the church that will be raptured. It's not a church. And then you watch the next video, the harvest cycles of Israel. And then after you watch that too. And then I'll explain to you the stages of all three, from the time of the resurrection of Christ until the end of the tribulation. And I'll do the first resurrection and the second resurrection. So set your notification for that video. Thanks so much.